In this video, I'm going to explain anatomy of rotator cuff. I'm going to explain their origin, insertion, function, and innervation. Okay, so there are four rotator cuff. I'm going to explain three muscles from this picture and the one muscle on the second picture. Okay, the first one is this one. This is supraspinatus. 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 This is the above spine of scapula. That's why this is supraspinatus. This is infraspinatus. Infraspinatus. This is infraspinatus below the spine of scapula. The origin of supraspinatus is supraspinous fossa. It's similar, right? Supraspinatus, supraspinous fossa. Origin of infraspinatus is infraspinous fossa. About this area, the whole surface of posterior surface of scapula. Infraspinatus, infraspinous fossa. Okay, the insertion of these two muscles are here. This is greater tubercle. Greater tubercle. Greater tubercle. It's the landmark of humerus. Okay? Supraspinatus. Infraspinatus. And the innervation of these two muscles is same nerve. This is suprascapular nerve. It's kind of confusing, right? The innervation is by suprascapular nerve. Okay, so what is function of supraspinatus? It's abduction. Abduction of shoulder joint. Abduction is this way. Supraspinatus is very important for initiation of abduction. It's very tiny muscle, so it cannot exert the strong power like deltoid. However, this is important for initiation of abduction. Okay, what is function of infraspinatus? It is external rotation of shoulder. External rotation. Okay, the third muscle, what is this one? This is teres minor. Teres minor. Its origin is the lateral border of scapula. It's kind of the middle part of lateral border. What is insertion? Insertion is here. This is also greater tubercle. You know, greater tubercle here. So, there are three rotator cuff muscles attached on greater tubercle. What are they? Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor. What is function of teres minor? It's also external rotation. You know, there are not many external rotators of shoulder. One is infraspinatus, of course, teres minor, and posterior fiber of deltoid. There are pretty much three muscles which do external rotation. So this is very, very important. What is innervation of teres minor? It is axillary nerve. Axillary nerve. Okay, that's pretty much it. I just explained three muscles. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor. Then in next picture, I'm going to explain the last rotator cuff muscle. So, this is the last rotator cuff in this video. By the way, you are looking at the scapula from front view. This is on the anterior part of scapula. This is subscapularis. Subscapularis. What is origin of subscapularis? This whole surface of scapula. This is subscapular fossa. Subscapular fossa. Simple, right? Then, Its insertion is here. This is pretty much different from other muscles. Other three muscles attach on greater tubercle. However, subscapularis attaches on lesser tubercle. Okay, lesser tubercle is this part. Okay, then what is function of subscapularis? It is internal rotation. Remember, teres minor and infraspinatus was external rotation. But subscapularis is internal rotation. It's slightly different from other three muscles, right? Because insertion is lesser tubercle and function is internal rotation. And location is in front of scapula. So I think this muscle is a little bit slightly different from other three muscles. And what is innervation of subscapularis? It's subscapular nerve. Subscapular nerve. It's a little bit easy if you remember the name of muscle or location. Let's say this is subscapularis, right? Its origin is subscapular fossa. Its innervation is subscapular nerve. Remembering terminology is very, very difficult. However, if you remember one structure, it's easy to remember other structures. So I hope this video helps your understanding of rotator cuff anatomy and function. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.